فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، وعنا كتاب ثلاثة الأصول by شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. This is our fifth lesson, and we stopped at where the مصنف, the author, said الثانية العمل به. The first point that we were speaking about previously was knowledge. And now we're going to be moving on to the second issue, المسألة الثانية, the second point, which is العمل به. After the person has gained knowledge, then knowledge requests implementation. Knowledge demands implementation. Every knowledge that does not bring you implementation is not praiseworthy in our religion. Rather, it is a knowledge that is not beneficial. And the knowledge which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he praises, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised, is the knowledge that pushes the person to implementation, that the person starts to implement that knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ كَبُرَ مَقْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, O those of you who believe, why do you say that which you don't do? كَبُرَ مَقْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. It holds severity in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you to say something in which you don't do. Surah As-Saff, Ayah 2 to Ayah 3. وقال الله جل وعلا, Allah تبارك وتعالى also said, أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم وأنتم تتلون الكتاب أفلا تعقلون. Do you command the people good and you forget yourselves and you are reciting the book of Allah, أفلا تعقلون, don't you have any intellect? And these kind of topics, which is implementing the knowledge, you know, is one of those issues, wallahi, that a person should feel al-khajal, wal-taqsir. He should feel embarrassed, and he should feel shy, and realize that we haven't reached the caliber or the level that was needed from us in the knowledge that Allah has blessed us with, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the poet said, وَغَيْرُ تَقِيٍّ يَأْمُرُ النَّاسَ بِالتُّقَى طَبِيبٌ يُدَاوِي وَالطَّبِيبُ عَلِيلُ. One who is not pious is commanding piety to the people. A doctor who is curing, but the doctor himself is ill. So this is the position that I personally feel like I fall into. A person who is not pious himself is commanding the people to be pious. طَبِيبٌ يُدَاوِي وَالطَّبِيبُ عَلِيلُ. A doctor who is curing the people and he himself is sick. The first people who will be judged the day of judgment, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, is three types of people. And the hadith Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, and he narrated in Kitab al-Imara, باب من قاتل للرياء والسمعة استحق النار. Nawawi brought it in that chaptering. On the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن أول الناس يقضى يوم القيامة عليه رجل استشهد فأوتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال قاتلت فيك حتى استشهدت قال كذبت ولكنك قاتلت لأن يقال جريء فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار ورجل تعلم العلم وعلمه وقرأ القرآن فأوتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال تعلمت العلم وعلمته وقرأت فيك القرآن قال كذبت ولكنك تعلمت العلم ليقال عالم وقرأت القرآن ليقال هو قارئ فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار ورجل وسع الله عليه وأعطاه من أصناف المال كله فأوتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال ما تركت من سبيل تحب أن ينفق فيها إلا أنفقت فيها لك قال كذبت ولكنك فعلت ليقال هو جواد فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه ثم ألقي في النار. This hadith tells us, and the Baytul Qasid, the intent from this long hadith is, one of the people is a person who Allah has given him knowledge, and he will be reminded of the blessing of having this knowledge. And he would be reminded of this, and he would be told, and he would be then said to, what did you do with this? And he would start to say, I taught the knowledge that you gave me, O Allah. And it would then be said to him, no, you lied, you're a liar. But you learned this knowledge so you can be called a scholar. In other words, he learned the knowledge but didn't implement it. Every knowledge that does not benefit you in the sense where you don't implement it, then in reality you are in danger of severe punishments the day of judgment. Imam al-Bukhari and Imam al-Muslim, both of them narrated on the authority of Usama ibn Zaydin radiallahu ta'ala anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the Prophet said, يجاء بالرجل يوم القيامة فيلقى في النار فتندلق أقتابه في النار فيدور كما يدور الحمار برحاه فيجتمع أهل النار عليه فيقولون أي فلان ما شأنك أليس كنت تأمرنا بالمعروف وتنهانا عن المنكر قال كنت آمركم بالمعروف ولا آتيه وأنهاكم عن المنكر وآتيه. A man will be brought the day of judgment and he will be thrown into the hellfire. His intestines will be brought out and he would be circulating around with his intestines just like the donkey goes round. Then the people of the hellfire will come around him and they would say to him, so and so, what happened? What is your affairs? Were you not the one who used to call us to the good and prohibit us from the evil? He will reply by saying, I used to order you the good, but I never used to do it. And I used to prohibit you from the evil, but I used to fall into it. Also Imam Ahmed and Abdullah ibn Humayd and Ibn Abi Shayba and Ibn Ihibban and other than them, They narrated on the authority of Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَتَيْتُ لَيْلَةَ أُسْرِيَ بِي عَلَى قَوْمٍ تُقْرَضُ شِفَاهُهُمْ بِمَقَارِيضَ مِنْ نَارٍ فَكُلَّمَا قُورِضَتْ وَفَتْ فَقُلْتُ يَا جِبْرِيلُ مَنْ هَؤُلَاءِ قَالَ خُطَبَاءِ أُمَّتِكَ قَالَ خُطَبَاءُ أُمَّتِكَ الذين يقولون ما لا يفعلون ويقرؤون كتاب الله ولا يعملون به. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the night I was ascended up high, I came to a people who metal rods were cutting their cheeks. The metal rod was from the hellfire. Every time it gets better, then the metal rod is taken and then it's ripped with the, on their cheek. فَقُلْتُ I said, يَا جِبْرِيلُ The Prophet said, I asked Jibril, I said, Jibril, مَنْ هَؤُلَاءِ Who are these people? And then the Prophet was told, خُطَبَاءِ أُمَّتِكَ They are the speakers of your ummah. الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ Those who say, مَا لَا يَفْعَلُ That which they don't do. وَيَقْرَأُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ They read the book of Allah. وَلَا يَعْمَلُونَ بِهِ And they don't implement it. So this is very serious, that they got this punishment for having the knowledge and not implementing it. وَقَدْ كَانَ السَّلَفُ رِضْوَانُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ يَحُثُّونَ عَلَى الْعَمَلِ بِالْعِلْمِ The Salaf, the pious predecessors, they used to urge and push the one who has knowledge to implement that knowledge. Here we have Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. رضي الله تعالى عنه He said إن الناس أحسن القول كلهم He said the people They have perfected the speech All of them فمن وافق قوله فعله Anyone who his speech Goes in accordance to his action فذلك الذي أصاب حظه Then that one is the person who has gained a good portion وَمَنْ خَالَفَ قَوْلَهُ فِعْلُهُ And the one who his speech and his actions are not in correlation فَإِنَّمَا يُوبَخُ نَفْسَهُ That person, he's the one who has made himself into destruction. The Sahabi al-Jaleel Abu Darda رضي الله تعالى عنه He said لا تكون تقيا حتى تكون عالما ولا تكون بالعلم جميلا حتى تكون به عاملا أبو درداء رضي الله تعالى عنه he said you're not going to be a pious person until you're a person of knowledge and you will not be a person of knowledge until you are one who implements his knowledge the poet he said ألا أيها المعلم غيره هل لنفسك كان ذا التعليم تصف الدواء لذي السقام وذا الضناء كيما يصح به وأنت سقيم ابدأ بنفسك فانهها عن غيها فإذا انتهت عنه فأنت حكيم وهناك يقبل ما تقول ويقتدى بالقول منك وينفع التعليم وينفع التعليم O you who teaches other than himself why don't you implement that which you teach do you prescribe the cure for the one who is ill why would you prescribe it when you're the one who is sick Start with yourself from prohibiting yourself from your deviation and your corruption. If you do so, then verily you are a wise one. And only then would your statements be followed and would your guidance make sense. بِالْقَوْلِ مِنْكَ وَيَنْفَعُ التَّعْلِيمُ And your knowledge would benefit. Another poet he said, إِذَا الْعِلْمُ لم تعمل به كان حجة عليك ولم تعذر بما أنت حامل، فإن كنت قد أبصرت هذا فإنما يصدق قول المرء ما هو فاعل.
Your knowledge, if you don't implement it, it will be a proof against you. And you won't be excused for that which you already know. If you have come to know that which has been said to you, then make that فَإِنَّمَا يُصَدِّقُ قَوْلَ الْمَرْءِ مَا هُوَ فَاعِلُ. Then your speech and your actions will go hand in hand.
مالك بن دينار رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إن العالم, the scholar, إذا لم يعمل بعلمه, if he doesn't implement his knowledge, زلت موعظته, his reminder drops عن القلوب from the people's hearts. كما يزل القطر عن الصفا. The same way the water drops from the rock that has no surface. It just flows off it. ابن سماك رضي الله تعالى رحمه الله, he said, كم من مذكر بالله ناس لله وكم من مخوف بالله جريء على الله وكم من تال لكتاب الله وهو منسلخ عن آيات الله وكم من مقرب إلى الله وهو بعيد عن الله. ابن سماك said, how many people remind Allah تبارك وتعالى to the people, but he is one who has forgot Allah. How many people who put fear of Allah towards the people, but he fulfills that which Allah has prohibited. How many people recite the book of Allah when he is far from the book of Allah? How many people bring the people close to Allah when he is far from Allah تبارك وتعالى. فنسأل الله تعالى, we ask Allah, الصدق, truthfulness, والإخلاص and sincerity, في الأقوال والأعمال والأحوال, in our speeches, our actions and our situations. أبو درداء رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إني لخائف, I am scared, يوم ينادي munadin, when the day a caller calls, fayaqulu, he says, ya Uwaymir, he says to me, oh Uwaymir, faqulu, I say, labbaik rabbi labbaik, oh my lord, I am here to obey you, I am here to obey you. Fayaqulu, it would then be said to me, ama alimta, did you not have knowledge? Faqulu, I then say, na'am, yes. Fayuqalu, it is then said to me, كيف عملت فيما علمت كيف عملت فيما علمت. How have you implemented that which you know? And then he said, فتأتي كل آية في كتاب الله زاجرة. Every verse of Allah that prohibits comes to me, and every verse that commands comes to me, and it asks me, تسألني فريضتها, it asks me of its rights, its obligation. فتشهد علي الآمرة, the verses that command testify against me, and says, لم أفعل, you didn't do this. وتشهد علي الزاجرة, the verses that prohibit also testify on me, بأني لم أنتهي, saying that I didn't stay away from that which I should have. And then he said, فَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ, I seek refuge in Allah, مِنْ قَلْبِ اللَّهِ يَخْشَعْ, from a heart that doesn't find humility, وَمِنْ عَمَلٍ لَا يَنْفَعْ, and an action that doesn't benefit, وَمِنْ صَوْتِ اللَّهِ يُسْمَعْ, and a sound that is not heard. وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ, and I seek refuge in Allah, مِنْ دُعَاءِ اللَّهِ يُجَابْ, and a dua that is not accepted. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih min hadith Zayd ibn Arqam,
that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to seek refuge in Allah from a knowledge that doesn't benefit. He used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa'. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from a knowledge that doesn't benefit. The knowledge that doesn't benefit is the knowledge that a person doesn't implement. And that is what Fudayl ibn Iyad rahimahullah meant. لا يزال العالم جاهلا. That the scholar is ignorant. حتى until يعمل بعلمه, until he implements his knowledge. فَإِذَا عَمِلَ بِهِ صَارَ عَالِمًا. When he implements his knowledge, then and only then does he become a scholar. In terms of knowledge and implementation of knowledge, when it comes to leaving it in the Sharia, it's of levels. The leaving of implementations of level. There are some knowledge, if you leave, you will be a disbeliever. Number one. Number two, there are some knowledge, if you leave implementing it, you become a disbeliever. That's two. Three, there are some actions of implementation that if you don't do, it's disliked, which is three. Four, there are implementation that if you leave off doing it, it's mubah. It's your choice. يستوي فيه الطرفان. Doing it and leaving it is equal, no problem. So we have four levels of any knowledge that you have. If you leave off implementing it, you fall in one of these four categories. Either leaving that knowledge and not implementing it, it can either be kufr, it can either be ma'asiyah, a sin, it can be makruh, disliked, or it can be mubah. It can be something that you're not going to get a reward or a sin for it. What is it, the knowledge that if you don't implement, you're going to be a disbeliever? It is the knowledge of a tawheed and worshipping Allah alone. Once a person knows that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped, if he does not implement that in his actions, and then if he doesn't make sure his worship are only done for Allah's sake, leaving off that implementation is kufrun billah. So leave, فَكَانَ تَرْكُ الْعَمَلِ فِي حَقِّهِ كُفْرًا. Leaving this action now is disbelief. The second one, which is a sin, is a person knows أَنَّ الْخَمْرَ حَرَامٌ شُرْبُهَا. Drinking khamr is haram. حَرَامٌ بَيْعُهَا. Buying and selling is haram. But then what does he do? خَالَفَ الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي عِنْدَهُ. He opposes the knowledge in his mind. And he doesn't implement that. Which is what? Not to drink the alcohol. Not to buy the alcohol. Not to drink or deal with alcohol. He doesn't. Rather, he opposes that knowledge and he doesn't implement it. This one is what? This person, قَدْ ارْتَكَبَ كَبِيرًا مِنْ كَبَائِرِ الذُّنُوبِ. He has now committed a major sin. The third one is, مَا تَرْكُهُ مَكْرُوهُ. مَا تَرْكُهُ مَكْرُوهُ. Leaving it is disliked. And the example for that is, إِذَا عَلِمَ أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَانَ يُصَلِّ عَلَى هَيْئَةٍ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to pray in a particular way, وَصِفَ مُعَيَّنَا, and in a particular manner. And then a person comes and he opposes the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this particular sunnah, after having the knowledge, تَرْكُ الْعَمَلِ بِالْعِلْمِ الَّذِي عِنْدَهُ فَهَذَا مَكْرُوهُ. This one is disliked. Because it's not wajib. This action is not wajib in the salah. It's a sunnah. So if he leaves it, it's disliked. The last one is العمل بالعلم ترك ما حق. The third one is the fourth one, which is the last one, sorry, is ما تركه مباح. Leaving it is مباح. And this is from the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to walk, or the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to dress. هذه الأمور الجبلية الطبيعية. These were natural things for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Leaving it is mubah. Even that though you now have the knowledge of it, you can leave it if you want to, and there is nothing on you. I will conclude there inshallah ta'ala for today's lesson. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.